Hey guys, how's it going? SoCal here. We're going to do a sight change out on one of my VP9s today. And thought I'd take you guys along for the ride. I haven't done a sight change out or a product review on the old trusty MGW Sight Pro in a long time. And thought maybe I ought to do another one just to show you guys how I change out my sights. A lot of places around here kind of gouge you for that. And actually, it's hard to find a lot of like HK sights, SIG sights, in a lot of local gun stores around here. So I buy them over the internet, get them, and then first thing I want to do is put them on now. Can't tell you exactly how many sights I've ruined or slides, gouging them, trying to use various tools around the garage, trying to put them in. Finally broke down a couple years ago and bought myself this Sight Pro by MGW, and I'm not affiliated with them, not making any money, not tooting their horn for any good reason other than they put out a killer product, and I wanted to show you guys. So today we're going to be putting on some of these Trijicon HD night sights. They have a really bright yellow front sight. It's hard to tell from the picture there, but yeah, the front sight post is outlined in a fluorescent yellow. Just brings your eye right to the front sight. Dig them. I've been putting them on a lot of my carry guns, and the rear sight's kind of a U-shaped. That makes it easier. It's a little wider and it's deeper, so it makes it really easy to pick up that front sight super fast. So here's the sights I'm going to be putting on. It's Trijicon model number 600602. And I've got the VP9 out. I'll just show safety salad. We're empty safety. We're good? All right. Cool. All right, let's bust out this Sight Pro. So the way this thing works, it's a behemoth. It weighs about a metric ton. But I tell you what, it works awesome. So basically what you got is the ram, or the pusher, so to speak, that runs back and forth on this upper piece up here. It's machined really well. You can tell by these screws, they just slide right on off, or unscrew off. Screw off. Whoa! Alright, so you split the halves and the have-nots. And basically what you got here, this is the pusher, this is the part that runs in the slide, and then you have like this nylon, or it might be Delrin or something like that, that kind of hugs the slide over the top of it. It's adjustable with this thumb screw, so you can lock down everything. And then at the bottom piece, this is where the slide goes, and you have these four screws that kind of hug the slide. From side to side, they kind of squish it this way. And then at the bottom here, they have these kind of model specific little shoes, is what they call them. And it's just basically a little tool that you slide the slide on. Let me pull the slide off of this guy. And I will show you what I'm talking about. So you have your slide, HK. This is the USP, made for the USP HK, but it just so happens to fit just perfectly the VP9. So basically, this slides in on the same rails as the slide would. And yeah, let me put this thing together and I'll show you exactly what we're talking about. Okay, so we got the shoe back into the unit. And I'm just going to take and slide the slide on in. And I guess we'll do the rear sight first. So you can put the head on it two different directions, obviously. You can put it on this way. That's the direction you would for the front sight. Or you can put it on this way. It also depends on what direction you stick the slide in the thing. It'll go either direction. So I'm going to set this guy on here. And what we want to do is turn the side screws. Turn this to the side so you can see what I'm doing. just to kind of hug up that slide. You don't need them super tight, just to keep the slop out of it. We'll crank down the bottom just to lock it in place. Now this thing's like not going anywhere. And we'll screw the top down. And now we're all locked in. And then one thing you want to do is check where this tool is, where it's going to go back and forth. You definitely do not want to have that riding too low, or it's going to really jack up your slide on your gun. It'll put some nice grooves on there, ones you don't want. So as far as removing, super easy. Just start cranking, and it's pretty stiff. I mean, all guns are different, but you'd be surprised how much effort it takes to push some of these slides off. And we're almost there. You can kind of see. There we go. All right, so we're free. We loosened it up, back it off a little bit. And we should be able to just reach in and grab that sight. Pull it on out. Oh, we need a little more room. So there's the rear. Pull the new rear out of here. What? All right, so we got our sights out. I'll give you a glimpse of kind of what this one looks like. It's got kind of a serrated, or not serrated, but a textured back to it. The tritium lamps in it are really dull. They don't stand out. They're not in your face, and that's kind of what I like about them. But on the other side of the coin, this front sight is way up in your face. Super bright, and it also has a tritium lamp in the middle of it that lights up. It's also really fine. It's not some big huge booger. It's a really nice tight little dot in at nighttime. So I like that guy. So yeah, take the old sight, cast it aside, and we'll finagle. It's kind of hard to do backwards. See what I can do here. Get this guy up in here. I can't get it up in there, so I'm just going to take the top off. Whoa. All right, so we got the rear sight back where it belongs, up in the tool head. You can see it off to one side there. And basically, just like taking it off, you just crank it the other direction. Get it back on. And then as you're putting it on, you kind of just want to eyeball it just to see where you are. And typically just get it dead, well, not dead center, but, you know, just kind of keep an eye on it. Look at different little details on the gun to see if you have it centered up. Like right now, I went too far. If you look at the two edges of the slide, you can kind of see where it's off to one side. So we're going to come back the other direction here. It looks like a little bit more. Yeah, that looks about right. So we'll center this thing up, pull the top off. Loosen up our edges. Let's see what we got. Need a little more room there. Yeah. Yeah, it looks like it's a little... No, that looks pretty dead to nuts. What do you think? Huh? Yeah, it's a good looking sight. All right. Let's do the front. So same story, different direction. You still have to put the slide in backwards because most handguns have the little piece there for the recoil spring to hang up on. this on like so. See, make sure that the sight lines up between the tool. Make sure that we have clearance and start cranking. All right, we're free. That should fall on out. Yep. All right, let me put this guy in the front direction. It's just way easier to take it off than try to finagle and maneuver the front sight in between all that apparatus up in there. So this is the way it goes. And like I was saying, this company does make these shoes for pretty much every firearm on the planet. Like what's this one? This is for Smith & Wesson M&P. I got a few more in here, one for a 1911, one for a SIG, and you know, they're all those manufacturers basically have the same geometry amongst their guns. I think I have a couple more out in the garage for Glock and similar stuff. I won't bore you with the details. So yeah, okay, so we're in, and we're just gonna crank back the other direction, press that on. And the front sight's a little tougher to get on because there's a lot more room for error. So you just gotta kind of keep checking. The VP9 has a kind of this little rectangle that runs down the length of the slide. So it makes it a lot easier to kind of figure out if you got it centered up. And my thumb is stuck in here. I think we're pretty close, but I can't really tell, so I'm going to pull this off and have a look. Yeah, actually, I think I got pretty lucky. Looks pretty much dead on. So yeah, that's about how easy it is. It goes a lot faster when you're not trying to make a video on it. Got a mid burp thing going on right in the middle of my sentence. Hell's that all about? Now the VP9 is a little hard to get in here just because it's got that plastic, I guess Les coined the word bat wings on it. These little too grippy hoo-has. There you go. That looks pretty sweet. Digging that. Really good, bright, nice sight. And they just pick up really fast. And you can kind of see the horseshoe thing I was talking about, the way that rear sight kind of looks a little like a U. It just allows for a faster pickup, I think, of that front sight. It just pokes right up there. Yeah, so this thing is cool. I think it's kind of expensive. I think it was around $300, $350. That was several years ago when I bought it. Works killer. You know, like I was saying earlier, it's about $50 rather. About $50 if I wanted to have a local gun store around here do this for me. I just thought that was kind of retarded. I like to do a lot of stuff myself. That way I know it's done right, or I jack it up completely, but it's on me. And I don't like paying for people to do like super easy stuff. And for all the tool guys out there, it's a great excuse to go buy some more stuff, you know. So yeah, that's about it, guys. There's the MGW. I think it stands for Maryland Gunworks. Yeah, Maryland Gunworks. Right there, those guys. And Maryland Gunworks, if you're watching, send me a bunch of free stuff. I did a video for you guys. Yeah, so anyway, guys, this thing is awesome. Appreciate you guys watching. Don't forget to hit that sub button, hit the thumbs up, and stick around.